Hi, Tom Utell here today with Acre Technologies, and today with us we have Chelsea Campbell. Welcome, Chelsea.
Thank you.
You're with MMV Farms, and you are the grain manager, correct?
Yes, elevator that is manager. Correct.
All right. Tell us a little bit about your day-to-day role, if you would.
Yes, so I am looking at the markets all day long while they're live and even afterwards, because I have to look at our local bids. And even as far as the river goes, just to compare and see what's going on. Mm-hmm. Have to keep up with trucks, where they are, what's going on, get everything scheduled kind of for the next day.
I see.
See what the plan is.
Tell us a little bit about your past. Tell us how you got to where you are today. What challenges that you see? There's a lot there, so take it one step at a time.
Yeah, absolutely. So grew up on the farm, obviously. So I had a lot of hands-on experience there. I was in a tractor helping Dad when I could. Even if I wasn't driving it myself, I still wanted to be with Dad to see and understand. It was such a fun experience for me to be around everyone and, you know, mm-hmm. the craziness, I guess, of harvest mm-hmm. even. Through high school, I was in FFA. I was an officer there, so I learned a lot there. You know, you learn a lot of communication, I think, skills, and seeing all these people going to a state conference or nationals, you just meet a lot of people, a lot of connections, and that really grew with me, because I probably wouldn't have started in the grain industry if it wasn't for connections and talking with people and understanding, and you're different. You know, everybody has a different perspective. Mm-hmm. And so that was a big take on it. Then after high school, I actually thought I wanted to be an accountant, which I guess in a way, you know, numbers. So mm-hmm. it still came with merchandising. It's
sure.
just I went about it probably a little different than I should have looking back on it. But that's part of it. You know, I still learned a lot. And that's, I guess, now I'm back on the farm after being at a local co-op, and then I went into specialty grains, so organic and non-GMO. Oh, really? Learned a lot there. I mean, I think that's the biggest part with the ag industry, is just every day is a learning experience.
Right.
Challenges with that is that farming is kind of your male-focused, or mm-hmm. I guess I should say male-focused, and there's still an older generation to that that didn't have a lot of women in the ag industry the way that it is now. Mm-hmm. So you still have to overcome that a little bit when you're talking with them and learning, which also comes to each personality. You know, you're learning the personalities and how did they grow up, what are they used to, mm-hmm. and try to pull that into it. So mm-hmm. still challenges, but you just have to figure out and work with people, and you know, mm-hmm. it's no different than in almost any other job, trying to work with
right.
your employees.
So. Right. You know, I see it on a daily basis, more women in ag.
Mm-hmm.
What do you see today? What do you see in the future as far as what women can accomplish, the roles? Will they be accepted sooner? You talked about that just a little bit. Tell us a little bit about kind of where we're at and what you see the future being for women in ag.
Yeah, so I think that it's growing. It will continue to grow. You're getting this generation where the older generation is coming out of farming. They're kind of retiring and handing it down to the next generation, which is your younger generation, which is at this point a little bit more accepting of women in ag,
mm-hmm.
which I think is why there's such an increase already.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that continues. I mean, women want to get out there. They want to be able to say, I can do this just as good, you know, maybe if not better.
Mm-hmm.
They have other ideas to do things.
Sure.
Having those opinions in there, I think, helps a lot. And I know with Dad and I on the farm, you know, he sees things differently than I do, and we just make it work. I mean, you have to hear each other out on it.
Sure.
But I do think it's growing. I think that it's more of a conversation than where it used to be, you know, maybe 5 years ago even.
Mm-hmm.
I know when I was working at my other jobs before that, we actually went to a conference, and it was just women in ag. And so you have
really?
All these women there that are insurance, or your seed dealers, your chemical,
wow.
your merchandisers. I mean, it's everything, you know,
mm-hmm.
everything that you could imagine.
Mm-hmm.
And all these women in high school got to come and see and talk. You know,
mm-hmm.
you just talk to them and see what they do. And if that interests you, great. If not, you learn something new still.
Right.
So I
right.
think it's just more of a conversation right now.
Yeah. So the USDA has done some research And it talks about the number of females in agriculture and how it continues to grow. Do you foresee that it will continue to grow? If so, what effect do you see that that will have on agriculture? And paint the picture of maybe 5 and 10 years out. What do you think that looks like?
I do think it's going to grow. The main reason for that is because it's talked about more. I think women realize how much more they can do in ag. And again, the biggest part of that is kind of social media. Mm-hmm. You know, you're seeing the people doing the TikToks and the Instagram mm-hmm. reels, and that's technology now. Women are going to pull that in and say, hey, look at this. And right. then that's growing to other women and saying,
she can do it.
Wow, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. She can do it. Why can't I? Or I want to try that. And mm-hmm. if it doesn't work, okay, maybe mm-hmm. there's something else in ag. I can say even for myself, I mean, I see it more on social media now. So, you know, I was just in the planter the other day. Okay, never would I have thought that I was going to be the one planting soybeans this year. And mm-hmm. I think that's awesome and that's cool and I want to share that.
Mm-hmm. Not to get real personal, but tell us a little bit about your family life today. I know you're married.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about how your farming operation and your job of the markets, and I know that they can be gotten on your phone now and from home or wherever you're at in mm-hmm. the office, but tell us a little bit about how you juggle that, you know, and still be the mother. And the wife.
Yeah, so my husband and I have really had to learn this, and we're still learning along the way. So we have a little girl, she's one now, she's very active, and thankfully enjoys tractors too, just as much as my husband and I do. So during the day, my husband and I are both farming, mm-hmm. full on. As soon as my brother gets the tractor, I am straight to the babysitter to pick her up. But the fun part about it is that we actually get to go back to the field because her and I will go and ride with my husband and she gets that experience.
Awesome.
She gets to see that. And you know, mm-hmm. it's fun because she'll get to see that I work just as hard during the day mm-hmm. and now she gets to go see that.
Mm-hmm.
I think it really is going to open her up to see more and see what she can do. Mm-hmm. And that's a lot of where my drive is mm-hmm. because I get to show her you can do this too.
Right. Yeah.
It's not and just men
yeah.
that can do that.
Well, Chelsea, thank you very much for your time, taking it out of the busy day. We'll see what the markets did. And so I'm Tom with Acre Technologies. And until next time, thank you very much.
Thank you.